శ్రీ ఉత్తమరపు వెంకటేశ్వరరావు కాలేజ్ ఆఫ్ ఇంజనీరింగ్ అండ్ టెక్నాలజీ 2008 లో స్థాపించిన కళాశాలలో ఎంబీఏ నాక్ ఏ గ్రేడ్ మరియు ఐఎస్ఓ సర్టిఫికేషన్ సాధించిన మొట్టమొదటి కళాశాల శ్రీ ఉత్తమరపు వెంకటేశ్వరరావు కాలేజ్ ఆఫ్ ఇంజనీరింగ్ అండ్ టెక్నాలజీ త్వరలో ఎటోనమస్ కాబోతుంది.
2014 లో ఐఎస్ఓ గుర్తింపు, 2015 లో రాష్ట్ర ప్రభుత్వంచే ఏ గ్రేడ్, 2016 లో నాక్ ఏ గ్రేడ్, ఇప్పుడు ఎంబీఏ సాధించిన సంస్థ శ్రీ ఉత్తమరపు వెంకటేశ్వరరావు కాలేజ్ ఆఫ్ ఇంజనీరింగ్ అండ్ టెక్నాలజీ.
Last classes we discussed about the introduction to basic radar systems. So basic radar equation, losses, system losses, modified radar equation, applications of radar, etc. Now we are going to start the unit 2, that is a continuous wave and frequency modulated radar. Continuous wave and frequency modulated radar. So here the contents are Doppler effect, continuous radar block diagram, isolation between transmitter and receiver, non-zero IF receiver, receiver bandwidth requirements, applications of continuous wave radar, some problems related to the above topics, FMCW radar, range and Doppler measurement, block diagram and its characteristics, FMCW altimeter, multiple frequency continuous wave radar. These topics we will discuss in this unit. First of all, we are going to discuss about the Doppler effect. So what is meant by Doppler effect, where it is used? So Doppler effect, it deals with the change of wave frequency during the relative motion between source and its objects. It can increase, frequency can increase or it can decrease. So how it is defined, that is change of the wave frequency during the relative motion between source and its target or source and its objects. See, a radar detects the presence of objects and locates their position in space by transmitting electromagnetic energy and observing the returned echo. What is meant by returned echo? That is received signal. Returned echo means that is the received signal. Okay, a pulse radar transmits a relatively short burst of electromagnetic energy, after which the receiver is turned on to listen for the echo. The echo not only indicates that a target is present, but the time that elapses between the transmission of the pulse and the receipt of the echo is a measure of the distance to the target. So separation of the echo signal and the transmitted signal. Echo signal means that is received signal. So separation of the echo signal and transmitted signal is made on the basis of differences in time or frequency. Okay. Radar transmitter may be operated continuously rather than pulsed if the strong transmitted signal can be separated from the weak echo. The received echo signal power is smaller than the transmitted power. It might be as little as 10 power minus 18 that of the transmitted power. Sometimes it's also some less power also. It will be some less power also. Separate antennas for transmission and reception help segregate the weak echo from the strong leakage signal, but the isolation is usually not sufficient. So a technique for separating the received signal from the transmitted signal when there is a relative motion between radar and target is based on the change in echo signal frequency caused by Doppler effect. So Doppler effect deals with a change of wave frequency during the relative motion between the antenna, between the radar and its targets, radar and its objects or targets. So it is the change of wave frequency during the relative motion between radar and its targets. So Doppler effect is well known in the fields of optics and acoustics, that if either the source of oscillation or the observer of the oscillation is in motion, an apparent shift in frequency will result. So here the main aim is shift in frequency is the result. This is a Doppler effect and is the basis of a continuous wave radar. So if the R is the, suppose if you take capital R is the distance from the radar to the target. Here the radar has both the transmitter as well as receiver. So if the R is the distance from the radar to the target, the total number of wavelengths lambda contained in the two-way path between the radar and the target, that is denoted by 2R by lambda, 2 into capital R by lambda. The distance R and the wavelength lambda are assumed to be measured in the same units. So distance R and wavelength lambda are assumed to be measured in same units. One wavelength corresponds to 2 pi radians. The total angular excursion phi made by electromagnetic wave during its transit to and from the target is 4 pi R by lambda radians. If the target is in motion, here we have to concentrate on relative motion. So during the relative motion between radar and its target. Okay, if the target is in motion, capital R, the R and phase phi are continually changing. A change in phi with respect to time is equal to a frequency. This is the Doppler angular frequency, that is WD, Doppler angular frequency, that is defined as a change in phi with respect to time is equal to a frequency. This is the Doppler angular frequency omega d, which is given by omega d. It is basically omega d is equal to 2 pi fd, actually 2 pi fd, that is equal to d phi by dt, that is d by dt of phi value is d by dt of phi value is 4 pi r by lambda. Since initially omega d equal to 2 pi fd, r that is equal to d by dt of phi, where phase angle, phi is the phase angle. So phi d phi by dt, that is d by dt of phi is nothing but 4 pi into r by lambda. So d by dt of 4 pi into r by lambda. So that is equal 4, we can extract 4 pi by lambda separately, 4 pi by lambda into d by dt of r. So it is 4 pi by lambda into d by dt of r is nothing but vr, where fd is Doppler frequency shift. So vr is a relative or radial velocity of target with to radar. The Doppler frequency shift is fd is equal to, fd is calculated by 2 into vr by lambda. So lambda can be defined as c by f naught. So replace lambda by c by f naught, it is equal to 2 into vr into f naught by c. So 2 into vr into f naught by c, this is a Doppler frequency shift. F naught is a transmitted frequency, c is velocity of propagation, that is t into 10 power 8 meters per second. If fd is in hertz, vr in knots, then and lambda is in meters, then fd equal to 1.03 into vr by lambda. So the Doppler angular frequency omega d, what Doppler effect says, so it is the change in wave frequency during the relative motion between radar and its target. It is change in wave frequency during the relative motion between radar and its targets. So that is the Doppler effect. So here we have to separate the transmitted frequency as well as the receiving frequency, the echo frequency. So that's why here the Doppler effect is used. Okay, so here these are the terms. So this is the Doppler angular frequency, that is omega d. Omega d can be derived like this omega d equal 2 pi fd, that is d phi by dt, that is d by dt of 4 pi into r by lambda, or it is 4 pi vr by lambda. Okay, so and fd can be frequency shift, that is Doppler frequency shift is mathematically expressed as 2 into vr by lambda, or lambda is c by f naught, so it will become 2 into vr into f naught by c, and c is a propagation of velocity of propagation, that is 3 into 10 power 8 meters per second. So if fd is in heads and vr is in knots and lambda is in meters, then fd equal to 1.03 into vr by lambda. Okay, so like this mathematically it is expressed. The relative velocity may be written as vr equal to v cos theta, where v is the target speed and theta is the angle made by the target trajectory and the line joining radar and target. When theta equal to 0, the Doppler frequency is maximum. Theta is 0, that is cos 0. Cos 0 means it is 1, so vr becomes v. Okay, the Doppler is 0 when the trajectory is perpendicular to the radar line of sight, that is theta equal to 90 degrees. Theta equal to 90 degrees. If you see the relation between Doppler frequency and radar frequency, which is measured in megahertz. Okay, so the relation is like this. So it is a linear relation. As the radar frequency increases, Doppler frequency also increases linearly, like this, linearly. This is the linear relationship between the Doppler frequency and radar frequency, which is measured in megahertz. So this is about the Doppler effect. Next, coming to the continuous wave radar black diagram. Continuous wave radar black diagram. See, here it is a continuous wave transmitter having the frequency f naught. It is having antenna. Antenna, it will act as transmitter as well as receiver. So it will transmit the wave with the frequency f naught. This is the object. This is the object, and it will receive the frequency of the it will receive the wave of frequency f naught plus or minus fd, like this, and this will combine these two waveforms and give to the detector or mixer. Then beat frequency amplifier, it will be amplified by the beat frequency amplifier fd. Its frequency fd will be amplified by beat frequency amplifier, and finally it will give to the indicator. Here indicator is nothing but our human ear, and it is the frequency response. Response versus frequency is like a frequency response. A voltage versus frequency, like a voltage versus frequency. It will be explained in detail as here the transmitter, first of all, the transmitter, continuous wave transmitter, generates a continuous or unmodulated oscillation of frequency f naught, which is radiated by the antenna. A continuous wave transmitter generates a continuous oscillations of frequency f naught is radiated by the antenna. A portion of the radiated energy is intercepted by the target and is scattered some of it in the direction of the radar, where it is collected by the receiving antenna. Here it will access, this antenna will access transmitter as well as receiving antenna. Radiated energy is intercepted by the target and is scattered some of it in the direction of the radar, where it is collected by the receiving antenna. If the target is in motion with velocity vr relative to the radar, then the received signal will be shifted in frequency from the transmitted frequency f naught by an amount plus or minus fd, which is given by fd equal to, that is fd is nothing but a Doppler frequency shift. Fd is given by 2 into vr by lambda. So it is equal to 2 into vr into f naught by c, where lambda is replaced by c by f naught. Here we have plus and negative signs are there, plus and minus signs are there. What is the plus indicates, what is plus sign indicates, and what is minus sign indicates? Here the plus sign associated with the Doppler frequency applies if the distance between target and radar is decreasing. If the distance between target and radar is decreasing, that is the target is very closer to the radar. When the when the received signal frequency is greater than the transmitted signal frequency. Plus indicates the distance between radar and target will be closer. That is a closing target. That is when the received signal frequency is greater than the transmitted signal. Plus sign indicates. Similarly, the minus sign applied if the distance is increasing. So there is a farther distance between target and the radar, then minus sign is applied. It applies if the distance is increasing, that is a receding target. Earlier case, plus sign indicates that is a closing target. Minus sign indicates it is receding target. Okay, plus sign indicates that the distance between radar and target is very small. Negative sign indicates that the distance between radar and target is larger. So the received echo signal at a frequency f naught plus or minus fd enters the radar via the antenna and heterodyned in the detector mixer with a portion of the transmitted signal f naught. A portion of the transmitted signal f naught to produce a Doppler beat note of frequency fd. This is the Doppler beat note of frequency fd. Okay, so that f naught plus fd will be received by the receiver and it will be mixed with the f naught and it is received by the detector mixer. It is heterodyned in the antenna and heterodyned in the detector mixer with a portion of the transmitter signal f naught to produce a Doppler beat note of frequency fd. Okay, the sign of fd is lost in the process. So here there is no sign of fd here, so it is mixed here, so it will only f naught will result, fd will result. Okay, the purpose of the Doppler amplifier, here the Doppler beat frequency amplifier is there, that is also called as Doppler amplifier. The purpose of the Doppler amplifier is to eliminate echoes from the stationary targets and to amplify the Doppler echo signal to a level where it can operate an indicating device. So it is used to eliminate echoes means received signals, echoes from the stationary targets and to amplify the Doppler echo signal to a level where it can operate an indicating device. It might have a frequency response characteristics. So these are the frequency response characteristics similar to this figure. So this is looking as the same as a frequency response. Frequency response is drawn between voltage versus or current versus frequency. It is like this. Okay, it is also beat frequency amplifier. It is basically it is an amplifier. That's why these characteristics responses are like this. Okay, the low frequency cutoff it will appear at here. So how to get low frequency cutoff and high frequency cutoff? This is the maximum dB, maximum gain. So by lowering the 3 dB gain, it will cut the waveform at here and here. So it is low frequency cutoff frequency and here it is the high frequency cutoff frequency. So the low frequency cutoff must be high enough to reject the DC component caused by stationary targets, but it must be low enough to pass the smallest Doppler frequency. So it will allow the lower frequency, smallest Doppler frequency. Okay, the upper cutoff frequency is selected to pass the highest Doppler frequency. So lower cutoff frequency is selected to pass smallest Doppler frequency and highest upper cutoff frequency is selected to pass the highest Doppler frequency. The indicator, so finally indicator is there. The indicator might be pair of earphones or a frequency meter. We can use either pair of earphones or frequency meter here, indicator, which indicates the result here. So the exact knowledge of the Doppler frequency is not necessary. Earphones are especially attractive provided the Doppler frequencies lie within the audio frequency response of the ear. So here we will receive the Doppler frequencies. These are within the range of audio frequency of our audio frequency response of our human ear. Okay, earphones are not only simple devices, but the ear acts a selective band pass filter with a pass band of the order of 50 hertz centered about the signal frequency. So it's a range, the frequency band pass of order of 50 hertz range. Okay, the narrow band pass characteristics of the ear results in an effective increase in the signal to noise ratio of the echo signal. The narrow band pass characteristics of the ear results in an effective increase in the signal to noise ratio of the echo signal. With a subsonic aircraft targets and transmitter frequencies in the middle range of the microwave frequency region, the Doppler frequencies fall within the pass band of the ear. So the aircrafts and the applications like aircrafts and the middle range of microwave frequency region, so the Doppler frequencies fall within the band pass of the ear, that is more or less in the range of 50 hertz range. Okay, 50 hertz range. Okay, if audio detection were desired for those combinations of target velocity and transmitter frequency which do not result in audible Doppler frequencies, the Doppler signal could be heterodyne to the audible range. The Doppler frequency should be heterodyne to the audible range. If audio detection were desired for those combinations of target velocity and transmitter frequency which do not result in audible Doppler frequencies, the Doppler signal could be heterodyne to the audible range. It will mix it to the Doppler frequency will be mixed to the audible range. The Doppler frequency can also be detected and measured by conventional frequency meters, usually one that counts cycles. So meters, instead of ears, our human ears, we can use frequency meters also. These meters will count the cycles. How many cycles will come? How many cycles are there in that frequency range? So these will be counted by the audio frequency, and these will be counted by the frequency meters. Okay, this is the role of indicator here. Indicator must be either human eye or frequency meter, depending upon the range of the Doppler frequencies. Here we can use either human ear or frequency meters. Human ear will receive the signals with the range of pass band range of 50 hertz like that. And suppose if the frequency meter is used, it can, the Doppler frequency can also be measured or detected by the conventional frequency meters, usually one that counts the cycles, how many cycles are there in that. So frequency meter is used to count the frequency cycles. Okay, this is about the continuous wave radar black diagram. So it's a black diagram and it's a response, beat frequency amplifier response. So continuous wave transmitter, unmodulated signals are transmitted through this antenna to the target. And if the target is in a relative motion, so the waveforms will be scattered. So some of the waveforms will be scattered in the same direction of the radar. So those will be received by the receiver. So these are echo signals. These will be received. Echo signals will be received by the receiver with the frequency f naught plus or minus fd. Plus indicates that the distance between radar and the target will be very near, and minus indicates that distance between radar and target will be farther. So these will combine with the f naught and heterodyne with the mixer and detector or mixer. So these will resultant as FD, the frequency FD. It will be amplified by the beat frequency amplifier. Its response is like the frequency response of the frequency response between voltage and frequency like this. So here lower cutoff frequency and upper cutoff, if you indicate the lower cut off frequency and upper cut off frequency. Here lower cut off frequency signals pass the smallest Doppler frequency, and higher cutoff frequency is selected to pass the highest Doppler frequency. And the indicator may be either our human ear or frequency meter. That depends upon the range of Doppler frequencies. Okay, if the human eye, if the Doppler frequencies are in the range of human eye, then we will use human ear. We will use human ear here. These are with the range of frequency meter. Frequency meter is also used here. So this will count the pulses or cycles here. Okay, this is about the continuous wave radar block diagram, and earlier one is Doppler effect. So with this we will end the today's session, and in the next class we will discuss about the remaining topics.